What's up, y'all? My name is Nattie. Y'all already know.
It's your boy KevLuxe.
And we're here with another video for y'all. Another dropping gems. Because, you know, we like to help y'all out. Today, we will be talking about credit, which is something really important. But before we get into that, we're at lunch right now. And we are at a Mexican restaurant, so we're gonna be kind of eating at the same time. Right. They're recording the video.
So excuse us in advance.
Right. So, yeah, we decided to record this video because credit is one of the main reasons why we were able to do what we're doing right now. And we had to perfect our credit game in order to get into everything that we're doing. So we want to do this video early on in our channel, that way you start correct.
Right.
And
absolutely,
that way you are able to, you know, if you're really interested in joining this card game or any other business, because honestly credit is important for anything.
Thank you.
Credit is essential for anything that you're trying to do in life, business, personal life, everything. So
right after the number one component of life and like succeeding in life, I believe, is always determination and like dedication first and being disciplined. That's number one.
Mm-hmm.
So that's that. Once you master that, that's when you're able to put an account of all the other things that we're gonna be talking about later on in this video.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, and to help you succeed in life, is like she said, is credit. Credit is huge.
It's huge.
It's huge. A lot of people don't understand that when your credit is above a certain score, above a 700, in the 800s, you literally have the world in your hands to where you can do whatever you want to do.
It opens so many doors. So this is it. If you're young, please listen to our advice.
Yeah.
Start right.
Yeah.
It's way easier. That's one thing about credit. It's way easier to start right and build up your credit.
Absolutely.
Than to mess it up and then try to fix it.
Absolutely.
It takes time and money.
So and I've been in that position to where ran up credit cards and different things like that, and to the point where I felt, I was just like, I don't care. I'm not going to pay it. And I think this message that I'm about to tell you is just a quick message. Like, one thing my uncle told me at some point, a millionaire told me, actually. He just said, like, whatever's on your credit right now, are you going to let that stop you from being a millionaire? And by him saying that, he basically means is you have to pay your debt and you have to, you know, you have to take care of your business and maximize your credit so you could do other things. Because without credit, you can have all the money in the world, but without credit, you ain't gonna be able to get nothing.
Yep. So another reason why we think this is valuable information is because we will be giving you both perspectives. He comes from a credit history of fixing his credit. I come from a credit history of getting it right from the beginning. So we can tell you what to do in each case.
So, before we begin, we do want to let you guys know that we are not professional financial advisors by any means. So, we're not lawyers. We're just giving you advice on how we think you can improve your credit.
What has worked for us?
Yeah, by following what has worked for us.
And this has all been, just like everything else that we do, this has all been learned from mistakes, and it has been learned from our own research. Nobody came and you know, said to us, this is what you gotta do. This we always thank you.
Thank you so much.
And the
carnitas
bowl with the chicken.
Thank you.
That looks good.
Thank you. So we got
good
eats that just came in.
I don't know, but I'm feeling his plate more than mine. You want to switch? Yeah, like we were saying, we're not professional advisors at all, and we're providing this knowledge for you guys from what we've learned from our own research.
educational standpoint.
Yeah.
Nothing more than that.
We didn't, well, we've worked with companies before, but we didn't, from the beginning, paid anybody to teach us none of this. So if we can do it from scratch, you guys can do it too.
We're going to get straight into it. There are five major components that make up your credit score. First being late payments. Payment history, late payments.
Huge.
That's very important. You have debt to income and usage ratio. Your length of credit is number three. Length of credit. Number four is mixed credit.
Was good, thank you.
Number four is mixed credit. And number five is new accounts. So let's go back to what I said for number one, right? And before we like deep dive into this, you have to make sure that you know what's on your credit. That's step number one, right? So let's backtrack. That's step number one. You want to make sure that you know what's on your credit.
Analyze your credit score.
Analyze your credit report.
And
not using Credit Karma. Credit Karma is not giving you the accurate day-to-day, monthly, you know, accurate score. It's not giving you that. So you need to, right now, pause the video, go to Experian.com. Experian.com gives you all three credit reports from all three bureaus. You have Equifax, TransUnion, and Experian. Experian.com. It will give you all three. You have to subscribe. I think it's like a $29 subscription.
I was paying $24.
Or $24 subscription. Even better. But it's worth it. It's going to be the best $24 you ever spend in your life because
it's accurate.
You're going to get, yeah, it's accurate. And it gives you real time of what your credit score is on a month-to-month basis. Mm-hmm. You can see all three and you can see your entire credit report. So that's the first step.
Mm-hmm.
Is making sure you check your credit report. And just seeing what's up there. See if you got any late payments, anything in collections. How long you had your last account? How long was it open? Different things like that. So let's get into the first one. What we said was payment history.
Mm-hmm.
Payment history takes up
35% of your credit score.
Of your credit score, which is huge. That means one late payment, if this takes up 35%, one late payment can make your score decrease almost 100 points right away. And when we say late payments, it's not your due date is today and you just missed it by 2 or 3 days. No. When you're considered late, the banks will report after you are late for 30 days or more. Right.
So you have a chance. Like if you haven't made a payment within the first 5 days, you still have a chance of paying, and you might still get fees for late payments. But depending on the bank and who you're working with. But it's not gonna affect your overall credit score.
Absolutely.
You have time. You have that 30-day period.
Don't panic and don't be that person to just say "F it, I'm not paying." Because after that 30 days, the longer you wait. 30 days and go to 60 days, it just decreases your score even more.
Right.
And then 90 days, it goes straight, 9 times out of 10, it goes straight to collection. So if you're just a few days late on any payment, call the bank. It's just like the bank is like, so people are intimidated by the banks and they think that it's like, oh, you know, this.
They're there to help you.
They're there to help you. So you have to just call, just like any other person, and say, hey, I'm going to be late. You know what I mean? And I'm going through this. I promise to pay on this date. Set up payment arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you're not considered late. So boom. Oh, sorry. I'm banging on the table. So that's major.
So another thing that we like to do to help with our payments is divide them in two. And he can tell you better how to do it in order to help your credit.
Well, when you divide it in two, for some reason it reports twice as opposed to reporting once.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting a better rapport with them by paying twice a month as opposed to paying one time a month. And then it just helps. People may think, oh, it's coming out twice, but like it's helping you because you don't have to pay as much up front.
Right.
And we can explain what the statement date opposed to the due date.
Right. So the statement date is basically whatever balance and yeah, whatever balance you have in your credit cards or account, that's the amount that is going to report on your credit. The due date is the date that they give you to pay the minimum amount, whatever you got to pay, the payment arrangement that you make with that card or bank. So that's the difference. Don't think that if you make a payment, okay, so this is important too. If you make a payment on the due date, but then increase the balance before the statement date, it's gonna, your payment is basically like you didn't do anything, because it's gonna report high again. So make sure that every time that you're making a payment, the balance is gonna stay the same until the statement date. After the statement date, you can increase it and pay it back again before the next statement date.
Right, so basically what she's saying is your due date may be, let's say for instance your due date is on the 10th. This is an example. Your due date is on the 10th. When you pay on the 10th, let's say you have a $100 card, they only give you a $100 limit, and your due date for that $100 limit is on the 10th. If you spent $100 that month and then pay $100 off on the 10th, you think, oh, it's zero balance, right? You have a zero balance. But let's just say on the 11th or the 12th or the 13th, you go out and you spend another $100. Your statement date is 4 days after your due date. So on your actual statement date is when the banks report to the credit bureaus, and they're gonna report how much you spent on that card. They're not gonna report, oh, they paid, on the due date they paid $100, so they're good. No, if you spent the $100 and then you paid it on the due date, and then 2 or 3 days later you spent $100 again, what's gonna report on to the credit bureaus is that you have 100% usage on that credit card or whatever it was.
Right. And even if you think, like, for example, oh, I'm gonna pay it right away, don't do it, because sometimes it takes a while for transactions to go through. So I've done a mistake that I thought it's okay because I'm gonna pay it right away from my other card, but then it takes a while to reflect, and it takes like 2 or 3 days to take the money out of your actual credit card, and then you're stuck with that high amount anyway.
Another tip for credit usage is maintaining only 1%, 1 to 3% usage on that credit, whatever credit line you have. So let's just say you have a card for $1,000. 3% is spending only $30 on that card.
Yeah, so don't think that just because you have, oh, I got approved for a $6,000 card, you can spend that whole $6,000, because it's going to reflect back on your credit.
You want to pull up your calculator, right?
And let's say $6,000, the amount that I said.
Right? $6,000. And then you want to times, I say don't go over 3%. So let's just say 2%. You want to stay between 1% and 3%. Mm-hmm. So 6,000, right? You times 2 and then hit the percent sign equals
120.
That's how much you should, your statement balance should be reporting as $120. Mm-hmm. Now, that's for excellent credit. Some people go 1 to 10%. Mm-hmm. But
it's still good. It's not bad.
It's not terrible.
It's not excellent. Though.
Right. But if you want we talking about excellent credit. So guys that just got a new car, this is something that you need to think about right now today. Like, okay, I just got approved for a $10,000 card, right? So I'm only gonna spend 3% of that.
That's doing all right.
Yes, ma'am.
Right.
3% of that $10,000 is only $300. That's what should be reporting. You do that for 3-4 months, it's gonna show that you, one, are disciplined enough to have a $10,000 card and still only use 3%. Mm-hmm. That shows the banks a lot. And mm-hmm. and eventually they start increasing your score more
because,
and more.
I'm sorry, because it shows that you're responsible with your own money.
Exactly.
Like, if you're not willing to overspend your own money, then they trust you to give you more of their credit.
It shows that you're responsible enough to not, you have $10,000 in your hand, but you're not using that full $10,000, right? Mm-hmm. And realistically, the banks do want you to use all that money because they gain interest on that money.
Right.
But they're gonna,
that's a trick.
That's a trick. But if you utilizing that 1 to 3% rule, and that's how much you're using on that car. Now, say for instance, if you have a $10,000 car and you use $10,000 on that car, just make sure that on your statement date, you go back to only spending $300. I mean, you pay it down to $300 of balance on that car.
Yeah, you just gotta time your usage.
Yeah, you just gotta time it. Like, and that's I feel like we explained it enough to where people can get it.
Mm-hmm.
Some people say 30. I know you guys heard, don't use over 30%.
We do 10.
We do 10.
That's how we've gotten to.
Excellent. It gets your credit up so fast, bro, if you do it exactly like that.
Yeah. Like, I've gotten my credit score all the way up to 770. Almost 800 points. And mind you, when you are an investor like us, the credit score will fluctuate. Like, it will go down with some investments, but if you study credit long enough, you're gonna know how to get it right back up.
Exactly.
So it's all like a game, but we're mainly teaching you how to get it right so you can start.
Right. The third major component of your credit score is
the longevity of your credit life. So, having no credit at all is as equal as having bad credit.
Absolutely.
You want to make sure that before you try to make any big investments or any purchases with a lender, you have credit history. Because if you don't, you're more than likely to get denied.
It's as simple as this. Somebody walks in right now while we're sitting here eating and say, hey, would you mind lending me $100? I'll give it right back. We're gonna be if we don't know him, we're gonna be looking like, who is this guy?
Mm-hmm.
He has no history with us. He's never paid us back.
We don't know this guy.
We don't know him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what are you doing here? You know what I mean? Like that. But anyway, so it's the same thing with the banks. They look at you, if you just coming in and you're trying to get a $10,000 credit card, they don't know anything about you.
Mm-hmm.
You understand that? So
right.
I want y'all to know that you have to have history with these banks in order to maximize what they'll give you in return, and then you finesse them back by keeping usage low and everything like that.
Right. So a lot of you might wonder, how do I get credit history if the banks are not going to approve because I don't have anything in my credit yet? So there's a few ways to do it. One of the main ways that I did it, and he actually teach me that or taught me that, is with secured credit cards. That's a big one. So how secured credit cards work is you go to this bank and you give them a portion of your money. You can give them $200, $500, whatever they accept. And then you use that as your own credit. So the credit card will have your own money, and it's like you're borrowing money from yourself. And that works because, first of all, the banks are not putting any money on the line. They're just putting their name. And they see that you're responsible enough to pay your own money on time, and that you're responsible enough as well to use a decent credit limit, like the 10% that we were talking about. Yeah, credit usage, I'm sorry. That's a big one. That's one of the main sources of building credit from zero.
Yeah, so it's just like she said, to start building credit, one of the first things that I would recommend doing is exactly that. Going to get a secured card. Take $500 of your own money, go in the bank, and you tell them I want a secured card. They're going to take that money, put it on the card, and give it right back to you.
Mm-hmm.
And as you use that money and pay it back, the money is back into your account to where you can use it again, revolving credit.
Mm-hmm.
So that's major. That's one major way. That's a gem. So if y'all don't know that, that's a gem. That's one major way to build. Even if your credit is already messed up right now,
you can still do it, and it'll help you a lot.
Go get it right now, and it will help you. And guess what? After 3 to 6 months of you paying that on time and you using only 1-3%, they will now turn that into an actual, not unsecured credit card, and they'll give you another, like, say for instance, you start out with $500 and you're paying on time and you know everything, doing everything right with it. I keep doing that. And doing everything right with it. They will now increase your credit limit and put they will invest in you now. So they'll put $1,000 on top of the $500 you already had, and then say now you have a credit line of $1,500, and then it's up to you to use that responsibly so that you can get even more money. Mm-hmm. The goal of this is to get them to keep increasing your credit limit. Keep increasing it. Stay, keep your usage low, but to get them to keep increasing it. Now you have a history with them. You're building, the length of the credit line is gonna be long, so that's another plus. And then what you're trying to do is make enough money to where you have enough capital to get into whatever business or investment you wanna do. And you can use your credit card for major investments. A lot of people don't know that you can use it for a down payment. You want them to do that. It's not the same going broke trying to impress. What is it? Trying to impress.
It's not the same going broke impressing than going broke investing.
Yeah, it's not the same going broke impressing than going broke investing. So if you build up that money and then now you like, okay, I got $10,000. Now when you open your business and you need the capital, and you know it's guaranteed to bring back residual income to you, now you could spend the whole $10,000 if you want to, but knowing that it's gonna come back from the business that you invested in. Mm-hmm. So that is the major play. Secure credit cards, let it build up. Let it build up, let it keep building. Every couple months, they just go, sometimes they just increase it. I know with Navy Federal, they just increase it. Like, you look at your card and be like, $4,500.
Like, out of nowhere.
$4,500, and it just go up from there. So that's major. Yep. Y'all need to make sure y'all do that.
Yep. So, yeah, so that's the main thing for building your credit from zero.
And listen, that is 15% of your credit, your score. That takes up, that's 15% of your score. So we had 35% for the payment history. We had 30% for the
usage,
and then we have 15% for the length of credit. Now we're going into number four, and number four is new accounts. New accounts takes up 10% of your screen.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Really sad happened.
New accounts takes up 10% of your score, so it's not major because it's only 10%, but it does matter because eventually you get new accounts. You have a good rapport with those accounts, and then you go back into the longevity of those, you know, those accounts. So the 10% now goes into the 15% because you get a new account, and then now you want to build a rapport with them for a long time, which is length of credit. Boom. So new accounts, very important that you guys know this.
That's a quick tip for that is getting that experience membership, like we said, and they will tell you the accounts that will approve you without credit history. So use that to your advantage. Get as many accounts as you can and pay them on time and use the credit wisely. And that, as many open accounts you have, the better, because it's going to show that you're responsible in different areas.
Exactly. Well, that goes into, so we can kind of say, new accounts, and the last, the fifth component is mixed credit.
Right.
So a mixture of credit. So
it kind of goes together.
That goes together. So we're going to talk about both of them.
Yeah.
With mixed credit, it means revolving credit, reoccurring credit. Like, so credit cards, auto loans,
mortgage loans.
Mortgage loans.
Personal loans.
Furniture accounts. Furniture, like
any type of loans.
Accounts. You have everything that we talk about applies to each account that you have. You want to make sure, even if it's a furniture, even if it's your phone bill, it's the same thing. You don't want to go over, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to step outside of what you can handle, but you do want to have a mixture of accounts. So another gem, major gem, is smart. Credit.com. Go to smartcredit.com, and they will give you a secured loan of like $1,000. They would literally, matter of fact, you give them $1,000, and then they don't give you anything in return, but you just pay on that per month. You just pay like a small fee per month or whatever like that to get it back down to $1,000, and once right. I mean back down to zero, and once it gets to zero, they'll give you $1,000. But that's a good way to start building your credit. That's smartcredit.com. And no, we are not sponsored by that, but that is
but
a
we will put
one.
All the links for all the websites that we've mentioned them down below, and you can get it straight from there.
Second
also,
one. Hold on.
Wait.
You got one more major one though.
I got one before I forget. Right, I'll be forgetting ahead, stuff. Go ahead. So make sure that all the accounts that you get are not above your income. So that's where debt to income ratio comes. So you don't want to have, yes, you want multiple different accounts, mixed accounts, but you don't want that to be above your income. So let's say if your income is $60,000 a year, make sure that the limit within those cards is $60,000. And that will show a good debt to income ratio.
Right, yeah, you don't want to be paying $5,000 a month out, but you only making $6,000
exactly.
a month. That's not gonna help you at all, because the debt to income ratio, that goes into component number two. The debt and you know debt to income ratio is gonna be messed up, and banks will look at you as a liability.
As a liability, yep.
And that's so another major. This is major, and I'm happy because this really will help you. So when it comes to mixed credit, the 10% of your credit score. And then eventually graduate into no late payments to, you know, usage excellent and debt to income excellent, everything like that. Secured credit card, you want to have an unsecured credit card. So eventually graduate to an unsecured credit card. You want to have the, I said smart credit earlier, but it's called Credit Strong. Go to creditstrong.com. That's where they will give you the secured loan. So go to, apply for creditstrong.com right now. That's three.
The jewelry spot.
You want to have My Jewelers Club. Go to myjewelersclub.com, and it's like cheap jewelry. It's nothing major, but they will give you $5,000, like a $5,000 credit line with them to pay to help you fund their jewelry that they sell. So you could buy like something cheap. I don't recommend buying nothing expensive. So. I can't really do the math right now, but let's just say they give you $5,000. You only want to spend money on something that's like within 1-3% what we talked about.
That rule is a golden rule.
It's a golden
that's
rule.
That's why we keep repeating it throughout the whole video.
Yes. So you want to spend 1-3% of that $5,000 on some cheap jewelry and give it for your little sister or whatever. You get it?
Why can't?
Damn. Get it for your
Why
ex.
Why can't they get it from this for themselves?
Nah, get it from your ex or whoever. I don't know. Just get some jewelry that's only 3% of that credit line. Once you get that jewelry that's only 3% of that credit line, you are now going to make monthly payments. Small monthly payments, $15 a month, because you're always going to stay in that 1-3% rule. So when your due date comes, you only spent up to the camera's giving us issues right now.
Right, technical difficulties.
You only spent 1-3%, so you don't have to do anything else but pay one time every month, like $15 per month, and that is gonna eventually keep bringing your usage down to eventually paid off, and then all you do is do it again. This is an easy gem that will help build your credit. You want to have at least five different credit things. So you got the secured, the unsecured, the jewelry website I told you guys about, and the Credit Strong website that I told you guys about. And then like you can open up like a department store. Don't go crazy. Don't go get the Victoria's Secret and the hot shit. Don't go get all that. Listen, get something for your business. Like if you own a
gas cards.
If you own a well that's yeah, gas cards is cool, but I think that's more on a bit when we give them a business credit side. That's
right.
That's more on a business credit side. But I would say gas cards is cool too, but I would say like say you have a lawn care business, get a Lowe's account, open up a Lowe's account, get something that's gonna bring you money in. Listen, assets over liabilities. We are not in this game and trying to build our credit so we can go get the flyest car, and flex, and be
unless paid. It's for business.
Unless it's for business purposes. But if it's not for business purposes and you don't have nothing to pay for that, then you don't want it. You're trying to maximize all these different accounts so that they see your length of your credit is really well, your usage across all of your accounts is within that 1-3% range. Oh man, I'm telling you, your credit will go crazy. Late payments. No late payments. We talked about that. We just kind of going over everything now. Late payments. We talked about that.
I mean, longevity.
Son.
It's so many things.
This information right here is major. Major. And that's why, like, I really feel good releasing this information to you guys, because it's really helped us. Like, not even kidding, it's really helped us. I could my credit right now, and as well as her, I could make that shit go to a 300 and we'll be able to increase
get
it all
the way
back up to an 850 if I need to.
And very important, that will happen if you're an investor and if you're in business. It don't trip about it. It's part of the game.
It's part of it. Guess what? My credit getting stomped on right now. A-town stomp. But it's cool because we know how to. We've invested a lot of money in the past 6 months. A lot of money.
The past year, I would say.
I mean, we've invested time, money, everything. We've invested a lot. But we built a plan of what we wanted to do. We had a plan of what we wanted to do. And we followed that plan, but one of the major things that we had to do, her credit, like she said, was already good. One of the things I had to do was bite the bullet and stop being stubborn and, you know, saying that I'm not going to pay this. And I sat down, I printed out my credit report. Once you print it out, you see what's on your credit report. You can see. And once you see that, now you can start tackling things. But if you're new to this and you don't have nothing on your credit, this is everything we just told you is golden. I guarantee
you're gonna get, if you do all of the steps, you're gonna get a 780 800 score within
this for the
next
people that don't have debt.
6 months to a year.
This is for the people that don't have any debt right now. This is for both sides, but
both sides.
We're talking about for the people that don't have any debt right now. This is golden. This is gonna take you to the next level. Your credit is major, because when you start jumping into the business credit and business funding, it all stems from your personal credit first. Right?
It's like, you know how when you go get a car, let's say, and you don't have the best credit, and they ask for a cosigner. With the business credit, it's the same thing, but you use yourself as a cosigner.
Personal guarantor. It's called a personal guarantor, and you will use yourself, like she said, as a cosigner. But that's a whole other topic.
Yep.
And we will give that to you guys. We want to see, like, comment below if you this has helped you at all. Comment below if you thought that the information that we gave today was
valuable
to you, your family members, everything. Oh, we almost forgot one major thing.
Why you look at me now?
Authorized users on credit cards. Authorized users. You want to be an authorized user on a credit card that of somebody who has excellent credit. So let's say your mom, your grandma, your uncle, you would tell them, "Grandma, I would like to, can I be an authorized user on your account?" She's gonna look at you like, authorized user, you're not getting my card. The good thing about it is you don't even need their card. They don't have to give you a card. All it does is everything that she does with her credit card, it reports to your credit report.
No, don't go to someone that has a bad credit score and has to be an authorized user.
Right. You want to get the people that got really good scores and that keep their usage low. And it's only going to help you because it'll show you. If you know your grandma been driving Bentleys and big old house, you know she's doing something right.
Right.
So it's only going to mold you. So if you want to be an authorized user on their account,
that's another way of building credit without any money or the credit bureaus having to trust on you.
Exactly. So, and what you would do, the step to that, the play to that is just having her go to the bank or call the bank. It's easy to just call, especially with like Bank of America, Navy Federal. They just call and say, hey, I would like to add authorized user to my account. They get your social, your date of birth, and that's it. And once they do that, instantly it will start reporting on your credit report. I always do that. Instantly it'll start reporting on your credit report, and that's a whole gem.
Right.
I'm telling you. So find somebody that has excellent credit, has great credit, and has, you know, credit cards that's that utilization is really low. Like y'all heard the 30% is low, and but I'm telling you 1-3%. I'm gonna tell you something that's going, we're gonna tell you something that's gonna take you to the next level.
Right. So that's pretty much it. Those are the basics of it. Obviously with credit you can go more, much more in depth, but that's the basics to start building a good credit score and to get your credit right at the same time if it's messed up.
Absolutely.
So follow us for more. If you like this video, this educational videos, we can definitely make more content like this.
We
appreciate you. We appreciate you for staying here and watching the whole thing. And listen, yeah, this is only for you guys.
I know it may have felt like we might have been all over the place in a way, but if you just watch this video through, rewind, you will get everything you need to know. And then if you have any questions, just comment below. We will direct message
definitely
you.
Reply.
We will ask you for your phone number. We will even give you phone calls, a phone call to let you know, okay, and tell you how to go about doing things. So you need to just watch this video
and take notes.
And take notes. Because everything we tell you, I promise you,
it's gonna help you. It's only gonna help you.
And I can't wait. I need screenshots. I need screenshots.
Yes,
I need
that would be awesome.
Tag us on Instagram if this has helped you. But I'm telling you, and if you do want like more financial literacy education or you know any other videos like this, we could tell you everything from removing inquiries off your credit in 24 hours to how to deal with late payments on your credit report, how to snowball debt, like how to get debt erased from your credit, not erased, but how to come up with a plan to minimizing that debt that you have.
Mm-hmm.
Everything.
Listen, like everything. We can get you right.
So
just follow us.
Make sure
to follow, like, comment, subscribe, all that good thing. Hit that bell so you can get a notification every time we post. And yeah, just stay tuned for more fire content that is only gonna improve your life.
Facts. It is. Oh, and then the car game. This applies to the card game. Everything we told you today, it does. If you're on our page right now because you're interested in joining the card game, this applies to the card game. First, you gotta get discipline. Second, you gotta go ahead and get that credit right. So go ahead and get that Experian account right now.
That's the first thing, guys.
That's the first thing.
First
step. See what's on your credit. Then go ahead and apply for that secured. And go ahead and go get that credit strong. Go ahead and get all that My Jewelers Club. All that. Get it. Get it today.
Right.
Oh, and when we told y'all to get mixed accounts, I want y'all to know this. Don't do it periodically to where you got an inquiry here, then you got an inquiry. If you're going to do your inquiries, get them all right away.
Mm-hmm.
While your credit is, you don't have no credit, get them all right away. Because if you get some now, you may not get approved for the next time you do it because you just opened up a new account previously. But if you do it within a time frame, then you're able to go ahead and get multiple accounts. So we love y'all.
Yes, thank you for tuning in and watching. And all of you guys that have subscribed, I know it's not a lot, but we appreciate y'all. We see y'all. We love y'all.
Thanks.
And thank you for supporting our business page, our YouTube channel,
Thanks.
TikTok, which is blowing up. We're going to put the link for all of that down in the description.
Thanks.
And yeah, we'll see you guys in the next video.
Peace.